Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And I am delighted to have my senior godbrother today on my channel. His name is Manas. He's Manas ji, of course. As you know, he had come long time back last year, and he had explained the transit of Sun from different houses. And now Sun has transited the ninth house. He has completed and he's about to enter the eighth house. So today is the eighth house. It's the dark house. And I will put the other two videos on the top at the end of this video. So today it's the most crucial feature of the eighth house. And once we complete this video, we will discuss about the next house where the sun sets. It is the seventh house. All right, so Manasji, welcome. Great to have you. Exotic Astrology, please enlighten us. And last two videos, so many of you have watched those two videos, and so many comments. Even now, even last 2 days back, I was seeing somebody was watching that video and they were commenting, you know, we want Manasji back. So the moment I came back to Germany, I told him, no, you must come, and he very kindly agreed to give me an appointment. And there you go, the stage is all yours. Welcome and please enlighten us. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, Bhavjit ji. Actually, it is my pleasure to be on your channel. So I am really delighted that people like the video. And the most important thing is that this is the way of Sun's transition is very much a good way to understand the properties of a house. So this is the thing. The main thing is to understand what is your depth of understanding. It depends like how good you are in assimilation multiple factors. So people when they understand, when they see same things from multiple aspects, the multiple aspects give them a perception, gives them a different perception. But when you are assimilating all these perceptions, you come to one perception, and that is the key perception which actually I am interested in sharing with all of you. So thank you so much. So our story begins from Sun's ninth house, and it is now moving to eighth house. So as we can understand, like Sun, when it is in ninth house, it is post noon time, something around 4 p.m. Yeah, so something around 4 p.m. Yeah, so after that, when it is moving to eighth house, it is actually what time it would come? Generally about
Around like maybe 4:30, around that time, depending on summer, winter. Yes, around that time.
generally depending upon summer, but I'm talking in context of Indian timing. So generally it would be 4:30 or kind of that.
Correct, correct.
So yeah, so at this time, if you will see, this is a time when Sun is, you will see, he has become lighter. No, its node is lighter. No, and you must have understood that in ninth house, it was have which was a house of spirituality. It was having totally bliss, total bliss. No, so what happens when it moves to the next house? Next of the spirituality. So the thing is that when you learn something, you actually learn when you make others understand. Okay, and how you will be able to make others understand when you are contemplating on it. That means, let's say, you learn something in mathematics, something in physics or some domain of knowledge. But unless you are not sharing it to some of your colleagues or some of your near and dear ones, you don't get a firm hold on it. And think when you are sharing with your colleagues, what happens? They ask questions. No, generally, if there is a serious seeker, they will ask question. Okay, and if they will ask question, what you will do? You will do contemplation. So the next level of understanding is what? Contemplation. When you contemplate, when you meditate on a particular thing for a longer duration, then you are able to master over it. You become master of it. And eighth house is specifically meant for that. So eighth house is surely deep meditation and contemplation will be the keyword for it. Now, I would like to understand it with the normal bhavad bhavam aspects. So just to give you a little bit idea. So let's say eighth house is seventh house from second house. Okay.
Correct.
So second, as I've mentioned, was an anxiety. Why it was an anxiety? Because you generally you are generally serious on few of the aspects of your life, like your wealth, your close-knit family members. So these all things are represented by second house. So it gives us a kind of an anxiety, an initial level of an anxiety. What does it actually mean? That you are actually concerned for them. Being concerned is not always an anxiety. That means you are not an anxiety, not in a negative means, but being concerned is mean something you are taking care of them. Now, when you are actually multiplying it multiple times, when your anxiety is getting multiplied multiple times, then it becomes eighth house, because it is a better half of second house.
Right.
It's a better half. So from the second house aspect, you can understand this. From the fifth house aspect, from the fifth house, it is what you can understand it from the fifth house. How many houses ahead are these?
Fourth house.
Yeah. So understand that fifth house, when it is like saying that your meditation has pulled your intelligence. That means you are so much meditating on a thing that your intelligence is being pulled into it. This is what it is saying, no? So why? Because 1 to 4 is a relation of mother and child relation. Your one was, let's say if I'm pairing with first house and fourth house, then fourth house is mother and first house is your gross body. Like that, if fifth house is your intelligence, eighth house is what? Eighth house is its mother. So if you are regularly contemplating, you are making your intelligence smarter. But yeah, there is a catch in that. In what all condition 5-8 may help you? One is that there's a real meditation, which actual sadhus do. Now, but if you will see this for a normal boy or girl, what does it actually mean? 5-8. So it will mean actually different thing. In that sense, again, that guy's intelligence is again contemplating on eight. But in this case, if it is a boy, girl, if it is a teenager, then this is a kind of mutual attraction, a kind of fascinating attraction. It would mean so the same, the combination, what I'm talking about, that if you can understand eight from the aspect of five. Now, let's go a little more deep. Understand it with respect of sixth house. Sixth house is what? Sixth house is generally like little kind of enemies, those enemies which you can actually conquer. these are not those enemies which you cannot defeat. Okay, so actually 8 is helper of those enemies, that means a friend of those enemies. So 6 alone will not create much problem. Even it means if 6 is alone, it is not associated with other 8th house, like 8th house, it will not create much problem in your life. But when 8 comes with it, it is getting a friend. Why? I'm giving you an example. So 6 is, let's say, one of its aspects is disease, a small disease. But if disease, you are continuously contemplating on that disease, oh, this is so bad, this is so bad, then it will be kind of a bigger, it will become a bigger pain for you. So 6, 8, when it combines, then it becomes a larger disease. So in all aspects, in a common understanding, you can understand that 8 is mainly circumambulating around one thing, and that is contemplation or meditation. I think this is all for 8th house.
Yeah, very beautifully you explained. And in context of the 5th house, I remembered a shloka that Krishna says in the Gita, Dhyayato Vishayam Pumsang Sangasteshu Bajayate Sanjat Sanjayate Kama Kamat Krodho Vijayate. So yes, when the mind is like, you know, the 5th house, the active mind, you know, 4th house is the passive mind. When the active mind is contemplating on the objects of the senses, then lust develops, you know. And krodhat bhavati sammurhat sammurhat smriti vibhrama smriti bhamshat buddhinasho. Buddhinasho is the fifth house, which is the intelligence, has gone to the 8th house. It's like buddhinash, that means the intelligence is destroyed. Buddhinasha pranashyati. It's like complete mayhem that occurs, you know. So yes, 8th house is contemplation. This is very beautifully you have explained. And whichever planet is linked with the 8th house, the 8th lord, wherever he is sitting, or whichever planet is sitting in the 8th house, I see it can make you sleepless sometimes, you know, because as you said, 2nd house is concerned, but the 8th house is the 7th from the 2nd. So it's like that concern which multiplies and does not let you sleep sometimes. Yes, so thank you very much for the 8th house, and Sun will transit to the 7th house very soon, and we will upload the video on the 7th house very soon. And if you like this series, which I am definitely sure you are liking, then please write it in the comments and watch the other videos which he has done. And I will post his email below in the description section. If any of you are interested to get a consultation from him, then well, he is always available. Oh, and yes, I forgot to mention, he's also teaching astrology. So can you please speak a few words about that? Where you are teaching, how you are teaching, and if somebody wants to learn, then how do they contact you for that?
Actually, for me, teaching is itself a pleasure, and it is for those who are actually interested in learning the science, in order to help the humanity. So currently, I have a very limited focus on a group of students. Time. Yeah.
that's okay. I mean, whenever you are ready to take more students, you can just let me and we can announce in the channel. And yes, okay, thank you very much. See you soon in the 7th house. All right, stay tuned, everybody.